analysis for the last 20 years, and he is every now and then, regularly we've seen on all the media channels, CNBC, NDTV, ET Now, and he's been there giving his market outlook and understanding of the market to the public in general, and we really are grateful for having Salil to come here.
So thank you for the welcome and all the nice words you spoke about me. A lot of things I share in common with Manoj, what he just said. He joined the markets in 92. I along with my partner Rahul Kapoor, we were practicing in the late 80s, and we switched to stock markets in 1990, so, and as a part-time thing, you know, thinking that maybe this is something which could be slightly different from the so-called, I know, boring audits and tax and work and all which we were doing. And then we encountered the phenomena of Harshad Mehta, and like what Manoj just mentioned, Mr. Manmohan Singh coming in. There was a budget which was presented in July 91 as against a February budget, and that was, as we all know, a remarkable thing which happened to this country, changed the fortunes and brought in the liberalization and the boom along with the budget. So if some people who were there, like Manoj, who at that time, we were just kind of carried away by what was happening around us, and we thought, oh man, this is a really amazing place to be in, because the kind of money one is making. And then in somewhere in February, March, we started idolizing this gentleman called Harshad Mehta. And we thought he's like kind of God reincarnate with his, those days Lexus used to be a very rare thing, but he was there and flaunting all those cars and beautiful residence and everything. So the thing was, you know, without seeing the fundamentals or the technicals, we hadn't heard of a technical analysis. We just went through things and which are going up. And, yeah, Mr. Rajesh. Hi.
Okay.
We are honored to have Mr. Rajesh Sharma with us as our chief guest. And Mr. Rajesh Sharma is the chairman of Northern India Regional Council of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. And he's been a great personality throughout. We have been watching him. And apart from supporting the activities of CA institutes, you know, to give the right guidance to CA students, he's been very active with the study circles. Very promising personality, and he is the national convener for CA members of the BJP cell. And it's a great job, I tell you, because he's been, it's all social activities which he's doing. And the type of support that he keeps giving to Atma and to his fellow brothers is remarkable, I tell you. It was him and Atma that attracted me to go back to the CA Institute after many years, because I generally don't happen to go there. And it's a great place, I tell you. And when I went to meet him, I would like to just share an incident with you, that since I was waiting for him, I wanted to have lunch. So I went to a dhaba there, you know, it was just nearby. So when I used to go to the library in 1990s, 89, I used to have lunch there. So when I went there, a gentleman was having lunch with us, and he said, you know, this, the son of this dhaba person he's also become a chartered accountant. You see that it's a blessing, I tell you. And when I met Rajesh ji, he was all supportive, all excited to come here and support the this educational activity and initiative of Atma. So we are grateful to have Rajesh Sharma ji here. Please give him a big hand. So I'll request Rajesh ji to please speak few words.
At the end.
Yeah.
I'm here to hear Mr. Salil, and it is a great time.
Wonderful.
Thanks a lot.
Salil, please.
Yeah. Continue. So I was telling you, Rajesh is telling the people like how I actually qualified in 86, and after that met with an accident. So then I just started. So we just talking about how I entered in the stock markets in 91. Like I was telling you that how the Harshad Mehta thing was going on, and we were seeing prices of shares, even like Tata Steel, which were shooting up, say, from 200-300 rupees to 900-1,000 in a matter of 4 to 5 weeks. And people were rushing to you, even though we were just novices in the stock market. And we had a client list the whole day. We were so busy, and so much of activity happening around us. So it's practically, you know, we were just kind of floating through that whole scenario. And suddenly in April, the whole thing came to a standstill, because at that time, the Bombay Stock Exchange people decided to go on a strike for some reason or the other. I mean, that's a complete irony for a capitalist system. The ultimate symbol of capitalism is going on a strike. And for nearly 4 weeks, I remember there were trades going on in Delhi in the curbs, and we kept hearing of phenomenal prices. But when the markets reopened, the crash started. And within a matter of a month, everything which was going up and shooting up came crashing down. Like in terms of the Bombay Stock Exchange index, it had gone up to, if I remember correctly, around 4,200. And in a matter of 3 to 4 months, it came down to around 2,400. So you can imagine the kind of misery which came after that. And then it, you know, made us thinking, what is exactly happening, you know. And so we needed some better kind of qualification or reading or knowledge to kind of encounter this beast known as stock market, because initially we thought what we had learned in CA, we were very well equipped and equipped to read all the balance sheets and all, and then understand how the things are functioning. But that obviously did not prove to be correct. So that is what, you know, finally I came across a book on technical analysis. This was on Dow Jones theory. And how I accessed this book is also very interesting, because one of my clients gave it to me, and he had taken a photocopy from the Delhi University. There was one book which was, you know, very old, and it had gone out of print. And from there, I started reading about technical analysis. And sometime during the Babri Masjid thing, we were staying in the Old Delhi area at that time. And during the Babri Masjid thing, there was nothing happening, no stock market, no activity. So, and I had this book with me. So I read through the whole thing once. I couldn't make a head or tail, but I read through it. Of course, the simple things were coming to mind, and then a lot of things I could identify what I was reading in there was exactly what had happened in the previous boom, which I had seen, the kind of the way the book described what happens at the end of a bull market, the kind of, you know, the shares which are referred to as cats and dogs starts moving up, and those kind of phenomena I was seeing, reading about, which I had seen actually happening in the stock market in the boom which had just gone by. One reading was not enough. I read that book at least 2 to 3 times to kind of understand and try to make out what exactly he was trying to get across. And despite the fact that, you know, like Manoj just mentioned, I've been studying this kind of field, the technical analysis, one is still a kind of student, because every time I listen to other fellow technical analysts on the TV or somewhere else, in some forum, every time you'd learn something new from them. So that is a very important thing for everybody to, you know, for any field, not just technical analysis, that you should be a kind of a willing student at every stage in life and not just a person who thinks that he has completely conquered any field, in this case, the technical analysis. So I think if you have that kind of an attitude, then you tend to learn more and you're not close to outside suggestions.